Good morning, dear children. So welcome to your new class. Now you all have come to class 8. So I wish you all good luck for the whole year. Please work hard since now you are in 8th standard. Now it's high time next year you will be moving on to class 9. So you have to be very sincere with your studies. So please do it regularly as we teach. As your videos are uploaded, watch the videos, try to understand. If any doubts, get it cleared also through WhatsApp or whichever way you would like to do it. So, but please be sincere to yourself. So today I'll start with the MCB and unit 1 I have taken up, chapter 1, that is Who Ate the Sun? So now you must be wondering, who will eat a sun? So, but yes, it happens that as we have seen the different solar eclipse or the lunar eclipse, during that time what happens? Someone, we feel that someone is eating the sun or someone is eating the moon. So today we are going to read, based on that, the myths that the people believe since ages, since generations, it is passed on by word of mouth, that what the people in those times have been believing. Okay, now this is our scientific era, so we try to believe according to what science says. But during those times there was no science as such, so people used to draw their own conclusions that what they have to understand by the various happenings which is happening during those times, whether it is the earth's natural phenomenon, whether something has been created by God. So everything at that time was occurring naturally because man was not so advanced to create anything. So they saw various things. They saw the forest fires, they saw solar eclipse, they saw lunar eclipse, they saw the occurring of night and day, and they also saw the change of seasons, they saw the growth of the plants, from where it is happening, how it is happening. So everything they have seen, and that was the first time these human beings, since they had no education, no knowledge, especially no knowledge, because when something occurs for the first time, we don't have any knowledge about it. After reading, after knowing, after listening to others, then we come to know, okay, these are the happenings which normally happen. So today you know that the morning when we rise, when we get up, it's morning. Why? Because the sun rises and sun sets in the west. Sun rises in the east and sets in the west. Why do you know? Because you have read it, because your parents have told you. So, but then in those times, people, they did not know about these things. So then what conclusion they derived from the natural phenomena which was occurring in those times? So today we are going to read about some of those and what are those called. So here, a myth is a story that explains the origins of a cultural practice or natural phenomenon. So now here, what is a myth? Myth are those stories which people believed because of any natural phenomenon. Okay, so with like your sun rises in the east and sets in the west. So today we know why this is occurring, because the sun moves on its own axis, that is called rotation. We know the change of the seasons are happening. Why it's happening? Because of the revolution of the earth. So here the earth moves on its axis, and that is called rotation, and because of that we have days and nights. And when the earth revolves, then we know that there is the change of seasons. And we also know that the sun does not move. The sun is stable in its own position. Rather, the earth keeps moving. And so there are so many natural phenomena. So a myth is a story that is explaining that in those times, the people used to explain that why this is happening, because others also wanted to know. So some clever person, he drew a conclusion that this is the reason why it is happening. So based on that, the stories that they have built up, so that is known as myth. Though these myths have no scientific reasoning. Okay, so only we call it as myth, right? So for example, almost all cultures across the world have a creation myth concerning the origins of the world or how the world came into exist. So now here, how the world started, how the first human being landed on earth. So these are several questions which arise in our mind. Though science has not yet proved it completely, but there are some assumptions by scientists. And same way, the people, those who all were living in those times, they also created some story without any scientific base. So those stories created by those people are known as myths. Okay? So read about some myths from different cultures. The word myth comes from the Greek word mythos. Mythos in Greek means story or speech. So the word myth is coming from the Greek word mythos. So we have the mythological stories you may have read in history. So the word mythos is actually a Greek word. So myths are stories that have come to us from the beginning of human existence. So since the time human beings have landed on earth or taken birth on earth or whatever it is, we don't know who were the first human beings who came on earth and how they came on earth. So they started building up these stories, and so those stories are passed on from generation to generation by word of mouth. So the very dawn of Indian history. So why it is called the very dawn? Because from the time the human beings have come, that is the start of our history. How history has developed or how human beings have developed as time passed. Okay. So the very dawn of history, and perhaps from the time humans started to speak. Yes. Once the language was decided, then human beings started to speak and started to have the stories. Before that, they had the actions only. By actions, the stories cannot be passed. Much of the stories could not be passed. But once the language came into existence, and then the stories could be carried forward from generation to generation. These stories try to give reasons for inexplicable phenomena that early man witnessed in nature or big cataclysmic events in human history. Yes. So these stories, how did they come up? So these stories actually came up because some change or the natural phenomena, or which are the inexplicable phenomena, means extraordinary phenomena have taken place, extraordinary happenings. Like you have your volcano eruption, that is an extraordinary happening. So these type of some phenomena occurred, because of which people became curious during those times also, and they wanted to know why it's happening. So some the clever people, the smart one, they started thinking over it, and they build up a story to explain it to the other people. So this way the myths came into existence. So these old stories try to give reasons for inexplicable phenomena that early man witnessed. Witness means they watched, they saw that earthquake, they saw the volcano eruption. So then they started reasoning and thinking that early man witnessed in nature or big cataclysmic events in human history. Every culture in the world has its own myths that are passed on from generation to generation. Yes, it happens by the word of mouth. So your grandparents, their grandparents, their grandparents must have passed several the situations, happenings, or the stories which have come to you till today. So your myths are far older than legends or folk tales and fables. So remember, myth started when human beings started speaking. Okay, so here, so that is the oldest one. So they are older than your legends or folk tales or fables. Now what are these fables? Fables are those stories which are, those are imaginative stories based on animals with the moral to teach the young generation something different. So these all were done since the olden times. So because they saw that the children are not listening or something, they wanted to teach the children. So this teaching part has started since ages. Okay. So here their parents wanted to teach their children something. So they built up stories taking the animal character, and every story had a moral. Okay. Because those morals teach us the values of life also. So like you have the tortoise and the hare, that slow and steady wins the race. So that is also a fable. It is teaching us some moral. It is giving us a message, which till now we read those stories and pass on those stories to our next generation also. Then you have the folk tales. Folk tales means, tales means actually stories again. Okay. And folk means about that particular local area. So like you have the folk tales of Madhya Pradesh, folk tales of Chhattisgarh, you have the folk songs, you have the folk dances. So everything means, folk means about that local area, whatever is related. Okay. Then we have the legends. Now legends means those stories which have some heroic deeds. Heroic means jaise bravery, the bravery has been shown to save someone, to protect someone. So those are known as the legends. Okay. So that is the legendary stories that also we get to listen to. So these are not as old as the myths, but these all are different types of stories. Okay. The earliest myths we know of are those that describe the creation of universe, of men, animals and spirits, and tell us of the origins of God. Yes. So now people are curious how the first human being came on earth, how earth was before that, how this earth came into existence where we have come to live, then how the animals came, how plants started growing, how God is there, is God there or not, that also we don't know. What are these spirits? Ye jo ghost, bhoot jo bolte hain, what are those? So these are so many types of questions arise in our mind, and we do not have any answer to those. Even science has not yet proved that. So these myths, when we listen to these myths, they try to satisfy us to an extent. Okay. We know there is no scientific truth in that, but still we try to listen and try to believe a part of it. Okay. So today, with the growing influence of rational scientific views of the world, when we use the word myth, we often mean something that isn't true, something made up to deceive others. Yes. So now here, today with the growing influence of rational means where we can think what is right, what is wrong, because we all are getting educated now. We all are seeing science developing. So we all try to think on that level, that what is true, what is scientifically proven. If it is true or not, then only we believe that. So here, today with the growing influence of rational scientific views of the world, when we use the word myth, we often mean something that isn't true. Okay. Something made up to deceive others. Deceive means to cheat others, to try to cover up a story. Okay. So that is known as a myth. So myth is, we do not believe, nowadays we all know that myth is not the real story, the real fact. But yes, we can just cover up that story. We can just try to, this must have happened. The olden people used to believe. That is what we say nowadays. Okay. But myths are perhaps necessary for the human spirit, as reality is too complex for the human brain to grasp. So the author says, yes, sometimes the myths satisfy us, that okay, this must have happened. And though we, a part of our brain also says that yes, it is not scientifically proven. So in this complex world, there are so many types of phenomena occurring. So we try to believe certain myths according to this. And it is too complex for the human brain to grasp, because many of the reality, the many of the things happening, it is difficult for us to understand, the human brain to take it, to grasp, to understand. Okay, we need explanations for questions that we cannot still answer based on our rational knowledge. So yes, many of the things, scientific happenings, we don't understand, though we have lot of questions in our mind, but still we do not get an answer to it, a satisfactory answer according to us. So we try to believe the myths. So myths satisfy us. What is our purpose? That is, there is a question. Yes, why have we come on earth? How did we come on earth? So what is our purpose on earth? Then where do we come from? What is reality? So these are various questions which we do not get answer to. Then what happens? To find the answers, sometimes if we do not get the scientific answers, we take the help of God, the religion that time. And whatever is told us, explained us in religion, in our religious books, we try to believe that. There are various stories in your religion. You must have seen, for every festival there is a story, and we do believe those stories that yes, this must have happened. Now recently you had the Holi festival, that why we burn the Holika. Now Holika, there is another story of Holika who sat with Prahlad, then Prahlad was saved and Holika got burned. So that means all the evil things should be burned. So this is what we believe. So these are according to the myths only. We don't know whether it is true or not. So here, science fiction could be regarded as a type of modern myth. Now, what do you mean by fiction? Fiction actually means is an imaginative story, not a real story. So science fiction means scientific imagination. So now, like, you have many stories like Ravan. You had a movie called Ravan of Shah Rukh Khan. So that is also scientific fiction only. And do we have like that clone and all? We don't know. We have never seen a clone of ourselves or anything. So Ravan is a good example of, you can say, the science fiction, where you are being told that this may happen sometime in future. So we don't know. You have the Star Trek series also. There also, those are also scientific fictions only. So science fiction could be regarded as a type of modern myth. So those are also myth, because those are not true. Okay. So children, I stop over here today. In my next class, I'll continue with this. Okay. I want you all to read till here. Go through the every line, spellings. Be thorough from starting. It will be very helpful. It will be very easy when you are appearing your exams. Okay. So have a wonderful day. Thank you.